Hey guys, it is Saturday the 28th of October 2017, day two of October's MCM Comicon. So, had a lie-in, it's about 10 past 10. I'm gonna get the tube to Comicon. Let's go.
You're watching nukemz.
Always vlogging. You're always vlogging.
Right, it's 11:30. I'm finally at the Excel Centre. And there's a lot of cosplayers out here, and it's actually quite nice weather for October. So I think before I head in, I'm gonna go try and vlog with some cosplayers.
I'm cosplaying as Hawkgirl from DC's Injustice Games, and yeah, it's been a great day. I've met some lovely people, and yeah, go all day.
It's really awesome.
Thank
How long
you.
Did it take to put together?
Oh god, in total, probably about 3 weeks. It's chicken wire frame and then about 400 foam feathers, all painted. And stuck together with a lot of hot glue.
Well, it's absolutely fantastic.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy the rest of Comicon.
Thank you. You too.
As expected, Comicon is so busy. So busy. I have just bought a book. One that I've wanted for a while. It was only £5. I was like, yeah, that's a good deal. Now I'm just going to keep wandering about and try and avoid the crowds. Found an amazing cafe. Can you tell everyone about your cosplay?
Cosplay? Well, this is my second time doing it. Second time going to London, so I'm really excited. I love Thor, so...
It looks really cool.
Thank
you. How long did it take to get
together? About a month. I'm not going to lie, this is like all papier-mâché, so it's all...
It looks really good. I'll plan it out.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
I'm mixing everything.
Yeah. And you enjoying the Comicon?
So good, yeah. It took a while to queue, but once we were there, it was really good.
Thank you.
You enjoy yours too.
At Comicon, feeling hungry, go to the Mound stand and get a free Mound. At Comicon, feeling thirsty, there's a free stand where they're giving away Diet Coke or Coke Zero. So I found another fabulous cosplay. Can you tell everyone about your cosplay?
Yeah, I am Wonder Woman, Gal Gadot Wonder Woman from 2017 movie. Nice to meet everybody. Hi! I'm having a great time here.
How long did it take to get
there? About me and my friend, about a month solid.
Yeah. I'll pan out and show them, it looks fantastic.
Thank you. Woo! Your face pose, there we go.
So, with it being Saturday at Comicon, it's really busy and really stressful and squished. So I'm going to go watch a panel on Doctor Who.
So we've got either or questions. So I'm going to throw one at you and just let me know which one you prefer.
Yeah.
Awesome. So, coffee or tea?
Tea.
Coffee.
Right. And books or movies?
Oh.
Is it possible?
Yeah. What about movies and books?
Movies and books. So we're going in the middle there, basically. Yeah. Are you an early bird or a night owl?
Night owl.
The same, night owl, yeah.
Introvert or extrovert?
I think I'm an introvert, but it manifests itself as an extrovert.
How did it feel? Bring that sort of story back to life?
It was very exciting. You know, it had been a project that was a long in the making. I think Mark wanted it to come out 10 years prior for that anniversary. So it felt like a really special thing to be a part of, because everyone, it was a passion project, you know, everyone really wanted it to happen. Everyone really wanted this story to be told. That was an amazing story.
Yes, probably. But I did like all the early ones, and John Pertwee as well. I just love the ones that have got the most eccentricity about them. And yet, they're not all-seeing, all-powerful. They're very, very vulnerable. I think you've got to believe that maybe the Doctor might fail on this thing. He's not Superman.
Two more colonel cosplayers. Do you want to tell everyone who your cosplayer is?
I'm pumpkin up in the Halloween crown.
And I'm Sandy Man.
They look absolutely terrifying. They look fantastic. How long have they taken to put together?
Well, it's taken a couple of months, but we're pretty much there now. So we're pleased with the costume. First time.
They look so good. And how's your con going?
We're having a fantastic day.
Great day. We have had an amazing time.
So many good costumes and so many good people.
Oh, I'm really glad. Enjoy Christy Comicon.
Thank you very much. You too.
I've found an amazing cosplayer. Do you want to tell everyone who your cosplayer
is? I am She-Ra.
It looks really awesome.
Thank
how
you.
How long did it take to get
about 2 days to put your mask.
And how's your combo?
Oh, brilliant. It's brilliant. I supported the free sweets. I'm going for those.
Just to meet you. Right. I'm heading to the MYM stage where there is a couple of guys who were in Merlin on a panel shortly. So I'm going to go check that out.
Cushion's performance, did you do to make it as accurate as possible?
I kept on and on. I was and am a huge Peter Cushing fan anyway, so that's why it's very daunting to be him. And I really, really didn't want to let him down, or indeed everyone who loves Star Wars. So I just watched over and over again bits of the New Hope, a few of the horror bits. Apparently Peter Cushing, he was so famous, many of you don't know, but he was very famous for playing horror characters, very frightening vampires.
Oh, that's just the schedule later on. Yeah, because you're here. How are you doing? Welcome to the stage. Oh, there we go. Just sit down.
Thank you.
They've been screaming about you guys for 5 minutes now.
5 minutes?
5 minutes, like, who loves Merlin? Who's excited about these guys? Who's excited about me? I like to get to know you guys a bit better.
Do you?
I do. And what we like to do is we like to do a game of, like, either or. And you're only allowed to choose one correct answer.
That's the game.
Now, in the past, we've actually had some of the celebrities falling out about it. So...
Are you ready to lose my friendship, Rupert?
Always.
Again.
How often does that happen?
Every time we play this game.
Alright, there you go. At least we're not playing Truth or Dare. Oh, we could play Truth or Dare. No. Okay, so I'll start off with an easy one. Coffee or tea?
Coffee.
So far, so good. Books or movies?
Oh, yeah. Do we have to agree?
No, you don't have to agree.
Oh, no, what, movies?
Movies.
So, we are agreeing.
Yeah, so far, so... You know what, I'm going to do jump straight to a tough one. Star Wars or Star Trek?
Star Wars.
This is too easy, isn't it? I need the... Dogs or cats?
We're not going to fall out. We're going to end up leaving here, getting married, having kids.
Yeah. They'll be good-looking kids, always. I've got to say.
Oh, with full beards.
Can I be Godfather?
No.
And obviously love you guys as well. They've got the hint, they're getting it. So what's it been like of just having such a huge fan base?
It's amazing and overwhelming. You know, the show finished 4 years ago, and every time me and Alex meet up to do these things, we always have that slight fear that we're going to walk through the doors and no one's going to want to meet us. And no one's going to turn up to these things. And it always is staggering. And more people are either watching it again and still loving it, or new generations of people are watching it. And it's great.
Thankfully, it's on Netflix, and I think Sci-Fi have just picked it up
just
as well.
About to put it on.
Yeah,
I think
again,
it's next week.
Which is amazing. And I mean, Rupert was in the show a lot longer than I was. I was in it for the last year. But the love that you have for Merlin is unfathomable. And we're so, so thankful. So thank you.
Thank you
round
very much.
Round of applause to yourselves. Come back, that'd be lovely. I said in an interview ages ago, and I'm going to stick by it, but I think if Mordred did exist in modern day, I think he would be part of the circus life. He'd be a sort of, you know, because he would still want to use his magic, so he would be part, or maybe a magician. Maybe just like a standard, maybe like Darren Brown. It's like selling out the Piccadilly Circus Theatre and all this sort of stuff, you know. Yeah, I'd love that. That'd be great. Modern day Merlin. We saw modern day Merlin hobo. Hobo Merlin.
That could be interesting. It worked for Sherlock, so it could work for you guys as well.
I think it'd be quite fun. It's just, again, the idea of doing it would be would be brilliant, and so many variations of what you could do with it. Yeah,
would you want your characters to keep their old memories, so it's just kind of in the future kind of way? I've given away now, but there I go. Would you like to have the same memories, or would you like it where the totally different memories and the characters start remembering what happens in the past?
I like that.
That's good. Yeah. I would just like to work with the guys again. We had so much fun on it, and we were such a good, and they were really like, you know, best mates.
I found this phenomenal cosplay. Who are you cosplaying
as? I'm cosplaying as Keyleth from Critical Role.
And how long did it take to put together?
Oh, quite a while. I was doing a lot of it last night. Probably a couple of weeks in total.
I'll come out and show them. It looks fantastic. How's your Comicon going?
How's my what?
How's Comicon going?
Oh, great, really fun. Very tiring. I'm going to have a sit down and just relax for a bit now.
Enjoy
you as well. Have a great con.
Has some friends at the authors on the panel, and she wants me to get the book, so I've got for her signed. So we're going to go and do that.
Virtual fighter that someone else is playing nearby, and it throws an awful lot of kind of gore on the screen and an awful lot of ideas, and it's the most French movie possible because it's 2.5 straight hours of Vincent Cassel and Jean Reno being disgusted at one another.
That was different. That was a very unique panel. Now, after I've got my books signed. That was very, very different. Very gory, lots of gore talk. But it was good. I got my books signed from my friend Rami. Now I'm gonna have a wander, because Comic-Con's about to close. So, yeah, Comic-Con has closed for today. I'm gonna head outside and see if there's any cosplayers to vlog with. Probably will be, quite a few are. So I found this amazing cosplayer. Do you want to tell everyone who the cosplayer
is? This is a custom design of Umbreon Pokemon. So just my own idea of the armor version.
It looks really, really good. How long did it take to put together?
This has been a working project since over a year now. I wore them the first time in October last year, and ever since I've been just been upgrading, enhancing step by step from then on. So.
And how's your con been today?
Heavy, quite heavy in this thing, so the breeze helps. So, yeah.
This
well for you.
Wait to see it. That's amazing. So, a lot of people are outside the Novotel over here. There's a lot of noise, I don't know what's going on, I'm going to go check it out, but unfortunately it's not very well lit. Let's go see what's going on. I don't know how much you could see, there's some kind of wrestling thing going on where people can just challenge someone to wrestling. Not really my cup of tea. I'm gonna head back, see if there's any more cosplayers outside the XL, and then probably head over to the O2 and edit this video and get it uploaded. Well, just after I filmed that last clip, they actually forced everyone out of the XL grounds and they started cleaning up. A lot of people are just like partying. A lot of people are leaving. So I'm gonna go and get the Emirates airline across the O2. And I think I'm gonna get myself a takeout Nando's and edit this video and get it uploaded. That was a lot of fun. Hope you guys have enjoyed today's video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Let me know who your favourite cosplayer was that I've vlogged with. If you want me to ask any cosplayers questions tomorrow, let me know in the comments down below. And I will see you tomorrow for day 3 of Comicon. Bye guys.
Subscribe to this guy for even more good times.